A stroke is when the brain doesn't get enough oxygen. The most common cause of a stroke is a blockage in a blood vessel to the brain, which is often due to a blood clot getting trapped where the blood vessel gets narrow. When the blood vessel gets blocked off, blood can no longer flow past the clot, and oxygen can't get to the brain tissue, and that tissue quickly starts to die off. Sometimes, though, that clot might dissolve on its own, before there's permanent damage. And this is known as a transient ischemic attack, or TIA, also known as a mini stroke, and symptoms typically go away on their own within a few hours. If a person's having a TIA, they should still go to the hospital, though, because it could be a warning sign that a larger stroke's about to happen. Now, knowing the signs and symptoms of a stroke can make a big difference in how quickly someone gets care, and in turn, how well they recover. Remembering the word FAST will help you remember the signs of a stroke. F stands for face, because usually one side of the face starts to droop and becomes hard to move. This can sometimes cause someone to smile crookedly. The next letter, A, is for arm weakness, or the inability to hold both arms out straight in front of the body. But it's not always just the arms. Sometimes a stroke can also cause weakness in the legs. S is for speech, which can either mean that someone's slurring their speech or having trouble understanding what others are saying. And finally, T is for time, because someone should call emergency services immediately when these symptoms appear. Now, strokes can also involve other symptoms, but these are the classic signs. So remember, face, arm, speech, and time, or FAST. If the healthcare team suspects a stroke when a person arrives at the hospital, a head CT scan can help to determine the underlying cause so that the person can be properly treated as quickly as possible. A stroke should be treated within the first few hours to improve the chances of a good recovery. Now, there are two treatments that can be offered in the first few hours of a stroke. After several hours have passed, these treatments will no longer work because the tissue can no longer be saved. TPA, sometimes known as the clot buster medicine, works by dissolving the blood clot and allowing blood to flow back through the previously blocked vessel. In addition, there's also thrombectomy, which is a minimally invasive procedure that can be used to remove larger clots from the brain. After a stroke, the main goal is to prevent another stroke. The most common modifiable risk factor for stroke is hypertension, or high blood pressure. Lowering blood pressure back to a normal range can result in the greatest decrease in stroke risk. Next, there's smoking, which approximately doubles the risk of another stroke. But this additional stroke risk disappears within 2 to 4 years of quitting. It takes most people several attempts to quit before they're successful, so it's important not to be discouraged after a failed attempt. Next, there's diabetes, which is a disease that causes high blood sugar, which ultimately damages the blood vessels. And finally, there's high cholesterol, which can lead to narrowing of blood vessels. All of these can predispose someone to having a stroke. But the good news is that they can all be reduced through a combination of lifestyle changes and medication. For medications, daily aspirin can be used to reduce the chances that a blood clot will form in the future. Also, though, blood thinners can be prescribed instead if someone has an abnormal heart rhythm like atrial fibrillation, since in these cases, clots are more likely to form in the heart and then travel to the brain. After a stroke, recovery can be slow, and sometimes people still see small improvements for a year or more. Depending on the type of stroke, individuals might work with speech therapists, physical therapists, and occupational therapists to regain physical strength and the ability to communicate effectively. Depression is very common following a stroke and shouldn't be ignored. It turns out that when it's properly addressed and treated, in addition to feeling better, people actually regain physical strength. And that's why having the support of family and friends, as well as healthcare professionals, has been shown to make such a big difference. In general, outcomes can be difficult to predict, and while most stroke patients have some permanent neurologic deficits, many people recover well over time, even those who weren't treated within hours of the stroke. Overall, the goal after a stroke is to provide tools to maximize quality of life and prevent another stroke from happening in the future.
Hello, I'm Dr. Isha Desai. We made this video specifically for individuals and families of people who've had a stroke. Every day we hear from people all over the world who've had various health conditions, and it's our privilege to serve them. We want everyone in the community to feel empowered to learn about their health, and we want both current and future clinicians to learn how to communicate this information to their patients. This is a slightly different video format for us, and we want to get it right. So please share your thoughts in the comments below so we can improve this kind of video in the future. Thank you so much.